My dear friends, I would like to welcome you in the excellent city of Tbilisi. I work at the company Scaleway, and I work there within this department. Why I would like to speak about it? All of these, the fabrics for the construction of the databases, etc., everybody knows about them. It is a very popular topic. But in my practice, it was the first project of participating in this type of the exercise. And all the time, we are facing some practical issues. So we have the practical issues, and how it should be organized, constructed, how it must be designed. My colleagues already had some experience. I also had some experience. Therefore, I decided to share some of the interesting aspects with you. How it the Scaleway, it's a French company, and it is engaged with the hosting, that part of the Lion Group, and we have some online the possibility about the selling of certain servers, as well as the cloud, the possibility, also virtual, the instances and surrounding ecosystem. Our infrastructure is quite a huge one. We are quite a big network company. About we have 100 physical servers in 5 data centers. We have 3.5 Tbps of internet traffic. Also, the several platforms, 3 or 4 the data centers, network architectures, the thousands and thousands of the different the platforms which in production, maybe they are, some of them are outdated, some of them are successful, some are not, but in fact we try to update them. We have then some platforms we are already IP fabric based, or some platforms needed redesign. Therefore, we took into account all of these the aspects. Therefore, we decided for us the business objective was to make the network the quite good for the multi-servicing. First of all, it is based on the internet. Within the network, we have the client instances, and as soon as we have these some internal instances, we need the multi-service approach. And everything becomes more difficult because we need to separate the client service from the internal one. Also, the scaling is a problem. And in addition, we also have the objective to do it very fast, because as usual, we everything needed to be ready yesterday. Therefore, we never had enough time for the development. That's why quite often, in a very hasty manner, we worked on this fabric. We all know what is the best fabric practice here. So scalable, the up to, etc. Without of the boxes, we cannot work with the IP fabric. What is the IP fabric? Let's, of course, you know about it. I'm not going to take much of your time. This is a classical, this three-step approach here. It is a cluster typology. It is by the Charles Clough, American mathematician, proposed. In the last century, when you have the leaves and spines, that we call them leaves, you know, and the spines, you know what is also in English. And we have this type of the construction, which can be reserved quite well. We also can add here the spines in order to make the traffic more excessive. And also we can add here the stores, layers, also increase the number of the stages, and we can scale in a deeper way. But taking into account our scaling, we have 5-step clause here with the super spines, and our scale is about several hundreds for the fabric. Yeah. For each fabric. The first step, it is underlay. Yeah? First, we just need ping between hosts connected to the fabric. How it must be done? I know that you talked about so-called proposal of the Peter Lapukhov, and we call him draft Lapukhov. But it was already adopted. It is not a draft any longer, and it is adopted at the RFC. And if you would like to build up the fabric, you have to take into account the draft Lapukov. Maybe all of you heard about him, but maybe not everybody read it. Therefore, you can find very proper questions as well as the very proper answers to them. He's proposing, by the way, to use the routing which will be similar to the internet. And what we do here, what we know here, it's an internet-like routing known to scale. As Jeb Houston said, we cannot understand in depth why so well scaling we have, but it happens, it happens. Therefore, one ASPN per level or one ASN per node, it's a one approach, or one to RENAs, for instance, the loopbacks only or links as well, so on leaf, on spine, or different numbers in either one, or BFD is necessary or not. I'm not going to answer these questions. You just can read it quite well to the RFC, and here you can find it, the numbers on the leaves, some the tricky things also we have used. Nothing is necessary to be a sound, nothing necessary to attribute these numbers, and no BFD is necessary, and also some additional complications, because the BFD and for BGP, in many cases, it is a bad idea. But also, we announce the addresses of the leaves under the links. All of these topics you can see in the draft Lapukov, you can read it. I apologize, Zhenia, we do not have the underlay IPv6 because they do not support IPv6. And for our network, our objective was to have possibility to provide to our clients the stack and dual stack, and also in reality, most available DC hardware still doesn't support IPv6 underlay for VXLAN. We have it in the V4, and as you can see, IPv6 underlay works just fine over IPv4 underlay. Now about the addressing. So addressing, in a few words, this aspect is not very well discussed or analyzed in the internet, but theoretically we have two ways for addressing. As it is in internet, when we separate the blocks, we also have the wrapping the same, which is the beloved one, then we identify the blocks, then we divide it into the sub-blocks, etc. Or there is another, we just take the typology. Typology, by the way, defines the addresses, like we have the telephone numbers when we give the zip code to the countries or the cities, etc., or the numbers as we have in the hotels, for instance, at the fourth floor everything starts on 4, at the fifth floor everything starts from 5, so the same is here. It has its pros and cons. Let's first speak about the pros. In theory, up to 100% numbering space utilization. Also works well to flexible also the underdefined topologies, and what most IP people are used to. They just are much better known. For the fixing, for the approach for the disease, it is quite a good approach. I did it many times, and we are using this principle when we codify the topology within the addressing. And it has, as I already mentioned, their pros and also their cons. First of all, it is easier for the people. It is a human market, because we can say that this switch at that spine works this way, or this leaf, or this spine. It is easier to identify. At the same time, it simplifies inventory of the process, because we know that all of these IPAM systems, they are quite a bit. It is headache, it is always disorder, etc. That's why we put the big prefix for entire fabric, and the others go to the geometrical way. From this addressing, the people are afraid of, because they are not accustomed to use this type of the addressing. When when you look at this scheme, you find very interesting aspects there. The connection between leaves and spines, sometimes are even numbers, sometimes are the odd numbers. So for the leaves, they are always the odd numbers. Therefore, we have to, here we can see we have the even numbers, as you see. I'm not going to speak about this scheme because you can find it in the literature. We like this approach. We like this methodology. We are quite satisfied with this. We are ready to say what is good and what is bad here also. Now about the overlay, the need for overlay. Here we have more difficult situation. Okay, we can forward IP packets from one network, the port, to another. What I talked about, the business wanted to have the multi-service network with the also to separate the internet traffic of the clients from the internal traffic, but for us, the internal requirement was just to satisfy this requirement. Services need isolation and overlapping IP space, security, hosting the internet, VRF should not have access to the block storage. Sometimes we speak whether it is good idea or bad idea, but we can do some VRFs and also some instances. Again, as I already mentioned, the standard de facto today is the protocol, the decapsulation of the WAN, and because the Cisco and Juniper, they are afraid of this market. We do not have the MPLS in our DC, so industry has the reinvented. So, as we see this encapsulation, as well as the data plane, is quite well decided here. This is the component which works from the hardware of most of our vendors. Therefore, so far we work quite well, and it is well investigated, the aspect, and also it is well documented. What is the overlay principle? The principle by itself, it exists in the operating networks, and we know quite well this picture when we have them for the clients, for so-called the green clients, we also have for the red clients, etc. So in these networks we have for many years already. It is our objective also to do it within the fabric and to do the same, almost the same. Now what we have beyond of the VXLAN, the traditionally the tool which from the very beginning the standard VXLAN had the control plane tool which could identify the traffic and routing of the traffic. So this mechanism was based on the multicast. But it does not work. So it is highly recognized as a bad one. The industry adopted, based on the consensus, that the more practical approach for the trafficking, it would be EVPN and BGP for the VXLAN. And the carrier MPLS networks have all the needed service, the signaling control plane tools. L3 VPN, L2 VPN, from the very beginning, this VPN appeared as a technology, some of the technologies of the L2, the replacement of the VPLS, because you know that it is the signaling using the BGP, but it is not so properly, let's say. Currently, today, we have the possibility to also provide the signal using the EVPN. It is not VPL on the steroids. So there are different the signals through the BGP, signals also some difficult routings, etc., which can also signal the MAC plus 3 and the others on the entrance of the device, but we use the routes of the type number 5. In contrast to classical L3VPN or L2VPN BGP families, it's not strictly limited to MPLS data plane. The VXLAN is one of the possible transports. There are different types of the transport, and one of them is the VXLAN. One of the conclusions, whatever I have mentioned above, if you are going to build up this type of the network or fabric, first of all, you need to know what is MPLS VPN theory, and that is the in the fabric, they do not show what is your target, what is zero distinguisher, etc. So this work, by the way, is the similar of the work of the BGP VPN. The many, many years, they are well tested in the operative networks. So it is very beneficial, first of all, to learn deeply this theory before you start with the VPL fabric. So it is not only for communication, for connection, because there is some cliche that it is for the communication of the segments from one side VLAN, from the another side VLAN, and through the L3 it can work. No, no. It is not only such a simple approach, because that is more flexible, more complex tool. Mechanism also provides possibility to do the other operations. Now what we are doing using the VXLAN L3VPN and its hardware challenges. Of course we have some difficulties when we want the L3VPN because there the leaves must know something to do. And if you are going to do it, you have to be very, very careful while considering with your vendors. In order to do L3VPN with the VXLAN EVPN and the VTEP must be able to perform an LPM lookup against the internal packet header. Therefore, I just advise you to be very sensitive to this issue before you start doing that. The next issue is how you can use this internet or the in a certain moment you need to make some gateway between the fabric overlay and the internet backbone. And there are the different approaches. Most of the vendors, if you open the document, we have the pines on the leaf, so there is some advantage. If you do not have the big network, in order to save some money, it could be interesting. But for us, it was not an interesting approach. It is complicating the spine leaf communication. Therefore, we decided not to link it with to the specific vendors, and in order to have them very, very elementary in their application. We made this type of the edge leaf. We have so-called the edge leaf. We have the pair of the leaves of the commutators, and they are quite specific. They are slightly different from the other leaf, they also work as a gateway between the underlay and the overlay. And on the other hand, they work as the internet backbone, and on the other hand, they also represent the part of the fabric, element of the fabric. As I already mentioned, all of this story is very similar to the MPLS network, and it is, of course, linked with the IBGP protocol. Underlay provides connectivity between leaf loopbacks, and each leaf has a pair of the sessions with IBGP, RCs to send and receive EVPN routers. And EVPN routes are used to forward endpoint traffic. So we can use it to send them to the commutator. Most popular is today, for instance, to some virtual machines, which has nothing about this overlay, but it can be work as a road reflector. But where we have to switch it on, where they must be located, so if we put it in our own cloud, it may not work, because it may not be the road reflector, because the entire network depends on it. Therefore, we have to think what it is signaling. That's why we selected the approach about the machine on which these the virtual machines are the routing, and to which physically we have to switch it on. because root reflectors on the spines shall be considered really in a very sensitive manner. We have some physical restrictions here, some limitations, because the interface is 100 the gigawatt, so here some maps, as well as some software, as well as the hardware of the servers. They need the special testing there. We didn't have them ready for the exploitation. That's why we derived reflectors connected with this interface. Most probably, if they had the possibility, maybe in the future we will change them and we will connect them with the spines, but today it looks like this way, and it is also possible for the exploitation. The road reflector is the virtual machine which lives within the hypervisor, and cannot physically see the links if, for instance, a physical link is lost with the network. Then any operation at the BGP, in order to keep it operational, also the road reflector can do it with the leaves in order to analyze the loopback, because all of the leaves are connected through the UPN. So it is spoiling everything here, because the road reflector does not know the condition of the physical connectivity. Therefore, here we also put the BFD. And that's why this particular switch, in the case of losing one communication, it can be switched only for a longer period of time. We have some problems with respect of the scaling, overlay scaling. And in some apps, the number of routes depends on the number of the hypervisors. So the scaling all of this community is really very important. We have some apps, number of which depends on the number of the traffics and the routes, as well as the location of the client, also their situation, including internet. Therefore, in other, it depends on the number of the VMS, and it is our challenge. We have a lot of VMS and can't have all the routes on all leaf VTEPS. So, this type of the routes are quite many, and we see the problem in scaling. What we invented, we called it with a modern word sharding. So in the EVPN, like other BGP, VPNs, uses the root target concept. And we have quite a complex the communication like extranet and the others. They are on the basis of the root targets. At the end of the network, we have one of the targets. At the end of it, we have some different one, because it is not easy to import or export them. So what we do, we just divide our VRFs, where we have the different routes, into the separate parts, smaller parts. And these parts represent as a sort of spokes. We use it in the so-called the hub spokes. And it is a very special device, providing more resources. It also has better capacity for scaling, and they can provide the entire view for the whole fabric. Therefore, the biggest part of the traffic, internet traffic, it goes from the north to the south. But the communication between these elements among the edge leaves, it is not very big one. And if we want from the left one to go to the right one, it goes through the edge leaf, and they will be communicating between the two balls. So we called it sharding. We use the word sharding. The tools which are behind all this the specific operation, they can found in the VPL system, in extranet and the others. That is widely known. This methodology, also playing with the targets, it's widely known. They are the absolutely classical for the operators network. That's why we need to make research about the BGP before you construct the fabric. So multi-homing option, it is quite a painful issue. Ideally, of course, it is excellent if we make the pure L3 for them based on the BGP, but the problem is that if we really would like to have the multi-homing options, then we cannot scale it. The tools or mechanisms for marking of the traffic, as well as of the VRF between the leaves and the hypervisors, in the case of the EVP, they do not exist. Next is some of the mechanism, like the multi-homing options. It's a classical standard approach, so-called ESI. It is very good, but it has the tricky things, and not all the vendors support it. And it is quite strange why, but the biggest part of the vendors, they do not support it, or only the few of them support. So the leaves which we use, they are not supported. Yeah, it's a very pity, regretfully, I have to mention, but it is the reality. Another impediment with respect to that is the overlay and balancing, because it is done on the basis of the SMP and it works only on the basis of the overlay routes. Alternative approach, which is supported by the majority of the vendor, it is the MC-LAG. You know that MC-LAG, that is some headache, I would say. We all know it. But there is no better solution. But it just works. But it is very much dependent on the vendor. So at each and every desk, we need the commutator connecting them, and we do not have the connection. And if something happens between the leaves, they may not be visible in the protocols of the amortization, because there are very special links on which we do not have the IT addresses. But the vendor said that it must be solved. Don't listen to them. It is not necessary to install them. So it is Anycast VTEP, and here you can use the extended loopback, which is used for the termination of those tunnels. Many of you maybe know that today we have the trend just use the hypervisors and what we have to do. So it's more and more common to terminate overlay directly on the hypervisors. Here we speak about the capacity, ability, etc. It's a matter of good implementation and performance. If you have good resources, it is okay, but if it comes from the resources which you are selling to your clients, then it depends on the trade-off. It means that you, for instance, sell for $3 for the virtual, but it is economic aspect. I don't want to say that we don't do it. We don't do it from the technological point of view, and we are not sure that we'll do it for entire traffic and for everything and everybody. A few words about the management. The most part of the producers, the manufacturers, they often ask for the OOB management. We think that it is not good, because just to put one switch at each desk, it doesn't work this way, because then we need the separate networks, then we need also the management of OOB. It is very expensive and not very reasonable. When we speak about the OOB, will be interface for the devices. Its implementation for the vendor, it's always interesting. Some of them have only 10 or 100. Some of them may not put it in the where I. Some of them may not use, for instance, routing, etc. Therefore, it is complicating the history. Therefore, we just simply use the underlay in our network, and also, in as we have separated the client, we can allow it ourselves. And for the underlay, we use this traffic. So we use it also for monitoring. That's all from my side. So thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Excellent presentation. There are two questions. Symmetrical RB and you, by the way, how you fought this issue? Because we heard that not all the vendors supported it. On the one hand, we have the multicasting system, and it is not so easy. Symmetrical or non-symmetrical, we have one and the same vendor everywhere. We do not face this type of the problem so far, but in the case of LPVPN, with respect of the routes of the type 5, we do not have this the double connection between the leaves. We have just routing. That is first. And the second question was about the multicast. We do not have it. It is just a routing, and we use the L3 VPN. Address family is just different. We do not have any multicast and all of these, let's say, not very pleasant elements.